ki mai taku manu, ka ke mai taku manu, te ki mai taku manu, ka ke mai taku manu, te tahatū o te wainui, te tahatū o te wairoa, ka tū te rupe ki tai, ka whakakiki, ka whakakakā, hara mai, hara mai, hara mai, hara mai. Hara mai koutou te piopa ras, hara mai, piopa hori, koutou, ko tau mai nei roto i tō tātou whare, o te karaiti te pauheringa waka e tūnei, rungi te marae, takoto iho nei, ai waho iho nei. Hara mai. Hara mai ki tā tātou karakie tēnei rā, karakie ka whakahau o tātou oati. I tukua e tātou ki mua te atua te wā, i whakawahia tātou i roto i te hāhia te atua. My great joy to welcome you here to the church, karaiti te pauheringa waka, Bishop Ross, Bishop George, those from the Diocese of Auckland, those from the Diocese of Polynesia in Auckland, and of course from Tamaki Makaurau. Welcome to this place for our service today of renewal of our vows. And of course, during Holy Week, we've had plenty of time to reflect on our own lives before God and before our neighbour. It's the first time we've had this service here at this church. Usually we're either at the Cathedral or at the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. This church, as I stand and welcome you, I'm reminded of Bishop Ben Tehara, who passed away earlier this year. I'm also reminded of Bishop Jim White, too, who 6 months ago died. And so they are coming fresh to me today as I stand and welcome you, because when I see your faces, I also see them. And in some way, they are present with us and all of those who have died in the last year. Currently, one of our priests died and is lying now in Mount Ruskell, the Reverend Miriamma Solomon. I attended the tangi last night, and her body shall be returned to the Hokianga tomorrow. Our sister in the priesthood, as we gather here and reflect on those who have impacted all of our lives. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. E te whānau a te karaiti, welcome to this holy table. Welcome to you, for we are Christ's body, Christ's work in the world. Welcome to you whose baptism makes you salt of the earth and light to the world. Rejoice and be glad. Praise God who gives us forgiveness and hope.
Amen.
Kia ia te whakamoemiti te kororia. I tonoa mai nei e te matua, hei whakahau i te ao, hei huri i te wai, hei waina, hei whakatahuri i te ngākau, kia tūtapu ai ki tōna aroaro. Tā pai atu o tātou ngākau ki ātakaraiti. Nāna nei whakatinana te kupu, hei toko i te ora, kororia ki a koe e te karaiti, whakatapua.
We come seeking forgiveness for all we have failed to be and do as members of Christ's body.
Mā te atu e muru o koutou hara, o tātou hara, kia mau te rongo, kia tātou katoa i tēnei rā. Kia koa, kia hari, ko te karaiti te aranga, te tāroi o te riri. Te karaiti te pau heringa waka. Whakapāingia te atua tō tātou kaihanga. Whakapāingia te atua tō tātou kai taurima. Whakapāingia te atua tō tātou kai unga ki te awha. Through us, God in Christ spreads in every place the fragrance that comes from knowing him, for we are the aroma of God. Ever-loving God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, you anointed your only Son as Messiah and Lord of all creation, and have given us a share in his consecration by making us members of his body. Help us to be faithful witnesses in the world to the salvation Christ won for all humanity. Through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Reading will be on the screen behind me. E soto sfumale lua fa upu mo mua fa ngata sfumale fa. Ona fetsa lai mai leo le li ia Mose ma Arona ele nu ai kopitso lo fa pe mai. E avele nei masina ya te oto ma ulua i masina. O le masina mo mua lava lea ya te oto ile tau sanga. Yo lua fa ya tu ile fa potonga uma o Israelu. Ia fa pe atu. O le aso se fulu o le nei masina, ia te itasi ai la tau malana tamai mamoe, i a inga o la tau tamā. O le a inga ma le tamai mamoe, pe a faifo e toi titi le a inga, e le mawhai o na umasa la tau tamai mamoe, o na la whaatasi ai lea male ua tua oi o le a inga, e tusa ma le faitau au fai o tangata. Ia whaatatau le tamai mamoe ma tangata la tau te ai ai. Ia sao ona le leila o tau tamai mamoe, o le poa, e tasi lona tausanga, tau te au mai ai i le lafu mamoe, po le lafu oti, tau te tausi iai se ia o atu i le aso e se furu ma le fa, o le nei masina, ona fasi ai lea i le faa potpotonga a to umo Israelu i le afiafi. Ia la tau ave foi nisi toto ma avatu i poue lua, o le faitotoa. Ma ona faa lava i lunga yo la tau fale, la tau te ai ai. La tau te ai fo i le tino i lea lava po, ua tunu i le afi. A tau fo i maa reto i le faa fefete ina, ma la au ona la tau te ina i ai. Au a tau te ai ai e faa po o tunua i le vai, a ia tunua lava i le afi. Olona ulu, ma ona vai, ma ona tōtonga. Awa foi nei ai se mea e toi, e o oile tae au. Awa se mea e toi, e o oile tae au, ia susunu lava ia i le afi. Ia whapea foi ona o tau a ai ai, o tau sulu ngā titi ia fusia, ma o tau see i o tau vai, ma o tau to to'o i o tau lima, tau te a ai ai whata lise, o le pāseka lava lea i le alii. Awa o le pōna nei, o te ui ane ai i le nuu ai kopito, ma o teia ulumatua umalava i le nuu ai kopito, o tangata a toa mamanu, o te whasala fo i a toa umalava ai kopito, o a ulava o le alii. E fai fo i le toto ma fai longa i a te outou, i fale tau te iai, o te vaai atu fo i le toto, o na au sasopo ai lea i a te outou, e le o fo i a te outou le mala e whano ai, pea o teia le nuu o ai kopito. E fai foi le nei aso, ma wha mana tunga ia te o tau. Tau te fai ai foi le tausaminga i le alii. E fai ai a o tau tupulanga amuli le tausaminga. O le tūlā fono e wha wavau. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church.
I love the Lord because he hears my voice and my prayer for mercy, because he bends down to listen. I will pray as long as I have breath. In my anxiety, I cried out to you. These people are all liars. What can I offer the Lord for all he has done for me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and praise the Lord's name for saving me. I will keep my promises to the Lord in the presence of all his people. The Lord cares deeply when his loved ones die. O Lord, I am your servant. Yes, I am your servant, born into your household. You have freed me from my chains. I will offer you a sacrifice of thanksgiving and call on the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
a reading from 1 Corinthians 11:23 to 26. For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Thanks be to God.
E tū whānau. Kia koutou, ki tau wairua anō. Te rongo pai tapu ki te ritenga i a hoani, te tekau mā toru o ngā upoko, ka timata i te rangi tuatahi. Praise and glory to God. Nā, i mua ake o te hākari, o te kapenga, ka māhara a ihu, Kua taka tōna wā e haere atu a ia i tēnei ao ki te matua, aroha ana ia ki ōna o te ao nei. Arohaina ana rātau tai anotia te mutunga. Ā, te mutunga o te hapa, kua whakamaharatia anotia ake anō hoki e te rewera, te ngākau o hūra i kari o te. Tama a haimoana, kia tukua ia, ā, ka mahara a ihu, kua oti ngā mea katoa te homai e te matua ki ōna ringa, i haere mai ia i te atua, e hoki atu ana ki te atua. Ka whakatika ia i te hapa, ka whakarere i ōna kākahu, ka mau ki te tauera, ka whitiki i āia. Me i reira, ka ringihia e ia he wai ki te peihana. Ā, ka āna ka horoi i ngā waiwai o ngā ākona, ka muru hoki ki te tauera i whitikiria i āia. Ā, ka taia ki a haimona pita, ka mea tērā ki āia, e te ariki, e horoi ana koe i ōku waiwai, ka whakahoki a ihu, ka mea ki āia, e kore koe e mātau āia nei, ki tāku e mea, o tira, e mātau koe ā mua ake nei, ka mea pita ki āia, e kore rawa koe e horoi i ōku waiwai, ka whakahoki a e ihu ki āia, ki te kore a hau e horoi i a koe, ka hore au wāhi i roto i a hau. Ka mea a haimona pita ki aia, e te ariki, awara ko ōku waiwai anake, engari ko ōku ringa me tōku mātenga. Ka mea a ihu ki aia, ki te mea i te kaukau tētahi, ka hore atu he ana, he aha mana, ko te horoi anake i ōna waiwai. E mā katoa ana hoki ia. E mā na koutou o tirā ka hore katoa. I mōhio hoki ia ki te tangata e tukua aia. Koia ia i mea ai ka hore koutou katoa i mā. Ā, ka oti o rātou waiwai te horoi. Ka mau ia ki ōna kākahu. Ka noho anō nā ka mea ki a rātou. E mātou ana i rānei koutou ki tāku i mea nei koutou. E karangatia ana hau e koutou, e te kaiwhakaako, e te ariki ā, he tikata koutou kōrero ko a hau hukia. Nā, ko horoia nei o koutou waiwai e a hau, e tō koutou ariki, e tō koutou kaiwhakaako me horoia no hoki e koutou ngā waiwai o tētahi o koutou. Kua hoatu nei hoki e a hau, e tauira mō koutou, kia rite ai, tā koutou mahi ki tāku i mea nei ki a koutou. He pono tāku e mea nei ki a koutou. Ka hore te pononga e nui ake tōna i tōna rangatira. E kore anō te tangata e tonoa e nui atu i tōna kaitono. Ki mātou koutou ki enei mea, ka kua ki te mea tia e koutou. Nō tōna rironga atu ki waho, ka mea ihu, kātahi te tama te tangata, ka whakakorore atia, ka whaikorore anō te atua i aia. Ā, ka whakakorore atia te atua i aia i roto i aia ake. Inā, ka horo tāna whakakorore i aia. E ngā tamariki, puto kaunei tāku noho i a koutou, tērā koutou e rapu i a hau, ko tāku hoki e mea ai ki ngā hurai. E kore koutou e āhei te haere ake ki te wāhi, e haere ai koutou āhau, ko tāku kupu anō tēnā kia koutou. He ture hau tāku ka hoatu nei kia koutou, kia aroha koutou tētahi ki tētahi. Kia rite ki tōku aroha kia koutou, wai hoki kia aroha koutou tētahi ki tētahi. Mā konei ka mātau ai te katoa, he ākona koutou nāku me ka aroha koutou tētahi ki tētahi. Aroha mai. Te rongo pai tēnei a te karaiti. Whakamoemititia ia.
God of peace, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you. Amen. It has been a big year. And at a North Shore clergy cluster group meeting last week, some of you were there, we had a discussion on the past year. And the conversation was not about liturgy or parish picnics or Lenten study programs, all those exciting things that bring us together as Anglican clergy. But rather we talked about tsunami warnings, volcanic eruptions, in floods, and a global pandemic. And if anyone was listening from a distance, they could have been excused for thinking that we were doing a Bible study on the book of Revelations. But as we all know, it has been a year full of anxious moments and uncertain predictions. Early last year, if we had watched a movie on our year gone by, we might have been tempted to say it was a bit over the top, a bit ridiculous even. But the year gone by has been a year we will never forget in our lifetime. It will remain in our memory, collective and personal. And memory is a powerful force in our lives. Memories make up part of our personal identity, built on past experiences. But they also form who we are as a community. So you could say memory is a community builder. Memory can bring people together with their shared experiences. And worthwhile memories both unite and remind. Within each of our tikanga, we experience different ways in which memories are passed on from one tupuna to another, one ancestor to another. We will be familiar with memories that are told and retold as we gather with tupuna, and also our parents and aunties and uncles. And sometimes we can get tired of hearing the same old story over and over again. And sometimes we hear quite different versions of the same story. The handing down of memories is important to our identity, to who we are, to the way in which we be whānau. Without remembering, we lose our whakapapa and we can lose ourselves. Today, we remember Jesus' Last Supper with the disciples and the washing of the disciples' feet. This memory has been passed on to us by all those who have gone before us in the Christian faith and through Holy Scriptures. We remember the story of the people of God. But memory is not simply about remembering. It is about how that memory has formed us and continues to inform us as we be the body of Christ in the world today. And in doing so, ordinary elements become extraordinary through the memories they represent. As we pray that God will bring us new life in the renewing of our vows today and the blessing of the oils, we recognise that ministries we offer to and with the world and the oils that we offer blessings with become extraordinary and holy. And we gather to do this every year, with only a few exceptions, last year being one of them, but we still did gather in a different way. And when we do gather, we do so recognising that repetition not only reinforces memory, but also becomes a proclamation, a witness to the event. So each time that we gather together, we proclaim God's love. We are witnesses to Holy Scripture. When we gather as we are today, we are reminded of Jesus' last days on earth. Memory helps us learn from the past and live more fully into the future. So how can our shared memory inform our actions today to live more fully into the future? What do our baptism and ordination vows say that inform our actions? And how does Scripture speak into our present? Now, these are big questions, and I invite you to contemplate, if you have time, as I know it's a busy time for you, but contemplate as you move through the next few days these big questions. Today, I would like to offer some reflections to assist in that process. And Scripture is always a good starting point. And just to say that the interpretation, the English interpretation, was on the PowerPoint, not in your book. So just to in case you got confused about that. It is about an Exodus story. Our first text is a bit of a challenge. This is a violent biblical text. And to simply gloss over that point is not helpful as we interpret Scripture for today. And what is the most difficult aspect here is that God appears to be the violent one. God is portrayed as a jealous, judgmental, and angry God. It reads, "On all the gods of Egypt, I will execute judgments. I am the Lord, I will strike the land of Egypt." This is powerful language, and not necessarily in a good way. Throughout the centuries, such theology, such collective memory, has resulted in reinforcing that abuse and control inflicted on others is okay. Our church story in this land holds such pain. But it gets worse. We also see in the same text where the firstborn are killed, both human beings and also animals. Is murder or violence okay when it comes to justice? Of course not. So what is this text saying to us? Firstly, what is important is to recognise, and most of you will, that context in which the story of the people of God is told. In this instance, the Exodus text is about survival. It presents a plan that included staying at home and fulfilling rituals that were required to survive, which were unique to that context. Does that sound familiar? If we, in the future, were engaging in the writings of the people of God in this present moment in our world events, they would be told to wear face masks, wash their hands for 20 seconds or two happy birthdays, everyone to social distance 2 meters apart, stay at home, and if you can't stay at home, scan the QR codes so that the government of the day know where you have been. Not to mention not travelling overseas unless you are then in managed isolation for at least 2 weeks when you return. If that was read as what the people of God should do, even 100 years from now, let alone 2000 plus, without context, that would be extremely confusing and actually highly problematic. This highlights that the story of the people of God is not a blueprint on behaviour for every age, but that through such stories we begin to understand identity and understand relationships with one another and with God. And they are informed by who and what has gone before us. Context is so important. So what is the overall message of our text within it and our context after naming that violence is not okay in whatever setting? If we are not to shy away from the difficult text and indeed the difficult times of our lives, past and present, how then do we face them? Our shared reality is that we live in a world where violence is experienced every day. And throughout the lockdowns, family violence statistics increased enormously. And such violence is not foreign to us, both within our lived experiences and also in our biblical text. When I have spoken to survivors of abuse and violence, some have reflected on how their story is found in these sacred texts. And that's really powerful. For me, the overall message that this particular text speaks about is the importance of the gathered community. We read, if the household was too small, they should join with its closest neighbour. In other words, they should connect and work together to do what needs to be done. It is in community that abuse and oppression is best faced and addressed. So it is with every community in every age and every context. We know that as we gather as community, we are strengthened by the care we have for one another. It is why our Prime Minister Jacinda recognised that and asking for us to be kind to one another as we went into lockdown a number of times over. Right across the nation, and indeed the world, people reached out to one another by Zoom, phone calls, emails, texts, and genuine care and love for one another. When in lockdown as the body of Christ, we shared prayer and resources across the internet with one another to ensure that we were reaching out to a world that needed words of lament and needed words of hope in a time of anxiety and uncertainty. Communally, we held one another. And in many cases, our young people led the way. But the global pandemic is not the only issue that we as a church and indeed our world are facing. We face a climate emergency. Many live in poverty in these islands, and we need to do something about it. We need to care for our vulnerable, and we need to own the abuse of those in our care. As you know, some of our bishops and archbishops have recently given evidence to the Royal Commission of Inquiry for addressing abuse and care in our land. It is an example of where our church recognises that we need to be accountable for the abuse and suffering that people have experienced in our churches, particularly in the past. We have not got it right. And it is through our humility and in our vulnerability and deeply wanting to change this reality that we can reach those who are the most vulnerable. And that is why the act of foot washing in our reading from John is so important. The very act of Jesus washing his disciples' feet encapsulates how we are to treat one another and how we are to be leaders in our world. The vulnerable state of humble service is the church's model of mission to the world. And this mission can be done by everyone, whatever role, title, gender, age, race. We can all offer service to one another. But foot washing is more than a humble act of service. It is a sermon to the world of how to love. But this love, and particularly the love of our enemies, is a revolutionary idea. If we are completely honest, love is terrifying. It puts us in a vulnerable space. It requires us to do things that we would rather not do. It demands we release our need to control, to acquire, to exert power over others, to exploit our own gain. Love requires a death of our own egocentric self, and for us to face our own guilt and brokenness honestly. This is how we as church can respond to this world at this time, in this context, to own our vulnerability so that others can live more fully. So how then do our vows inform how we respond to others' needs? The renewal of commitment to ministry that we will soon make includes having responsibility for those in need, for offering Christ-like compassion and humility, recalling those who fall away, and helping the sick and loving all people. In renewing these vows regularly, our memory is reawakened and we embody the call to service. We become the body of Christ and our memory becomes our witness. And the witness is about giving deeper meaning and responsibility to the ministry that we are all called to. So as our memory of Jesus' last hours on earth remind us, may we be open to love and service to others in all that we do. May our collective memory bring us insights and wisdom on how we reach people in our world today. Right now, as the pandemic continues to impact who we are, abuse and violence continue. Our planet moans through lack of immediate responses, and the poor and vulnerable struggle. Our world needs God's radical love in action more than ever. Let's do this together. Amen.
E te whanau te karaiti, Christ is head of the church and alone is the source of all Christian ministry. Through the ages, it is Christ who has called men and women to serve. By the Holy Spirit, all who believe and are baptized receive a ministry to proclaim Jesus as Saviour and Lord, to love and serve the people with whom they live and work. In Christ, they are to bring redemption, to reconcile and to make whole. They are to be salt to the earth and light to the world. My sisters and brothers, do you reaffirm your commitment to this ministry? Will you encourage and support one another in your various ministries, seeking always to be faithful stewards of the gifts God has given you? Will you be faithful in study and reflection so that you might be better prepared to share the good news with those you encounter in daily life? Will you seek to interact with God's people of other denominations and faiths to heal our divisions and to pursue our common mission? Ministry in Christ's name calls us to relationships of mutuality and reconciliation. Will you renew your commitment to the relationships with which you are entrusted? Those in lay ministry could remain standing. Sisters and brothers, we recall that there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are varieties of service, but the same Lord. There are many forms of work, but all are the work of the same God. At your commissioning, you dedicated your gifts to the service of Christ. Will you now rededicate yourself to your ministry in the church, thereby renewing your service to Christ? God of love, by whose grace alone we are accepted and called to your service, strengthen these your servants by your Holy Spirit and make them worthy of their calling.
Those in need are cared for with Christ-like compassion and humility. When called upon to do so, deacons may baptize, preach, and give instruction in the faith. Priests are called to build up Christ's congregation, to strengthen the baptized, and to lead them as witnesses to Christ in the world. They are called to be pastors, to share people's joys and sorrows, encourage the faithful, recall those who fall away, heal and uphold. Priests are called to proclaim God's word and to take part in Christ's prophetic word, to declare forgiveness through Jesus Christ, to baptize, to preside at the Eucharist, and to administer Christ's holy sacraments. Do you now renew your commitment to Christ in the order of ministry to which you have been called?
I commit myself anew to this ministry.
May God, who has given us the will to do these things, give us more and more the grace and power to perform them.
Today we recall how our Lord was pastor and shepherd to God's people. As our Lord has called you to this ministry as bishop, will you now, in the presence of God and of the ministers to whom you are chief pastor, renew your own dedication to Christ and to the service of God's people?
As a bishop, I will so dedicate myself to this ministry.
At your ordination as a bishop, you accepted responsibility for leading, guiding, and shepherding the people of God to whom you are sent. Are you now resolved to unite yourself more closely with Christ and to become more like Christ by freely giving of yourself to bring love, joy, and peace to your brothers and sisters and to the world?
I am so resolved.
Ministry in Christ's name calls us to relationships of mutuality and reconciliation. Will you renew your commitment to the relationships with which you are entrusted?
I will, and I seek to restore myself where those relationships have been broken or fractured. Glory to God on high, God of power and might. You are my God. I can neither add to your glory nor take away from your power. Yet will I wait upon you daily in prayer and praise. God of love, pour upon us, your servants, the great riches of your grace, that we may please you in all we do, and lead your people in ways of health and righteousness, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen.
Sisters and brothers, blessed be Christ, the Prince of Peace,
who breaks down the walls that divide.
The peace of God be always with you.
Praise to Christ, who unites us in peace. The Spirit of God be with you.
And
lift your hearts to heaven. Let us give thanks to God.
It
is the joy of our salvation, God of the universe, to give you thanks through Jesus Christ. He said, "Let there be light." There was light. Your light shines on in our darkness. For you, the earth, has brought forth life in all its forms. You have created us to hear your word, to do your will, and to be fulfilled in your love. It is right to thank you. You sent your Son to be for us the way we need to follow and the truth we need to know. You sent your Son to give his life to release us from our sin. His cross has taken our guilt away. Behold the man, the Savior who will not save himself, Creator whom the world disowns. His cross is the reconciliation. Christ is peace between God and the world, peace between the world and God. You send your Holy Spirit to strengthen and to guide, to warn and to revive your church. Therefore, with all your witnesses who surround us on every side, countless as heaven stars, we praise you for our creation and our calling with loving and with joyful hearts.
Blessed are you, most holy, in your Son who washed the disciples' feet. I am among you, he said, as one who serves. He said, "Paul, in your own mother, the family of the soul, the son of the best, I am with the papa. The Lord is your master, and the Lord is your time. The son of the son of the city, the Lord is your name, the Lord is your name, the Lord is your name." Thank you.
Be.
Jesus said, I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. Blessed be God who calls us together.
Praise God who makes us one people.
Blessed be God who has forgiven our sin.
Praise God who gives hope and freedom.
Blessed be God whose word is proclaimed.
Praise God who is revealed as love.
Blessed be God who alone has called us.
Therefore we offer all that we are and all that we shall become.
Accept, O God, our sacrifice of praise.
Amen.
Holy God, we thank you for the gifts you have given us in your love. We thank you for life itself and for the sacraments. Through the sign of chrism, you dispense your life and love to all people. By anointing us with your spirit, you strengthen all who have been reborn in baptism. You transform them into the likeness of your Son, and you give them a share in his royal, priestly, and prophetic work. So we ask you to bless this mixture of oil and perfume. Pour out the gifts of your Spirit on our brothers and sisters who will be anointed with this holy oil, that we may come to share eternal life in the glory of your kingdom. Amen. Amen.